Hey everybody, this is Willow, and I'm working to help people to wake up. I just wanted to hop on tonight and just talk to you guys a little bit about, you know, all the stuff that's going on with the coronavirus and, you know, this all the drama. And I mean, I know there's a lot of conspiracy theories going around, and there's a lot of people just blowing up, you know, the internet with all kind of ideas and things, and the media kind of blows stuff up, and we got stories about what's going on behind the scenes and with the cabal being arrested, you know, and then there's theories about everybody being rounded up and taken to FEMA camps and lockdowns and, you know, people dying. I mean, it's crazy. It's crazy right now. And I know that there's so much taking place, you know, and there's so much, people are in so much panic and fear, and we got to get food, we got to get water, we got to make sure we got everything we need. What if we lose power? What if we lose water? What if we lose internet? You know, we won't be able to come. Well, it's, yeah, all that's possible, you know, and it's real easy to get caught up in the fear and the panic. I know, because even myself, I've watched some of the videos, and some of it is disturbing, you know, especially when you see these videos about people talking about they're putting 5G in all the schools and all the businesses while we're in the lockdown, and when everybody goes back to school, they're going to get sick, you know, and stuff. And it's easy to get caught up in fear. It's so easy because there's so much out there. And I'm talking to myself too, because I'm guilty of it. But what I wanted to get on to say is, we really have to get centered, okay? We really have to get centered in our heart center. We have to get connected to our God source, because if we don't make the connection with God source, we're going to literally let all this drive us crazy. It can drive you crazy if you really get caught up in all the hype and all the panic. So I just wanted to say to everybody that it's so important right now, especially right now with what's going on, that we turn on our light, that we have our light on. Now, if you know what I'm talking about, if you're spiritually awakened and you know what I'm talking about by your light, I'm talking about having that connection with Christ within you, with God source within you. And if you don't know how to make that connection, or if you've never made a connection with God, now is the time to be doing that, because things are so uncertain right now, and we really don't know what's going on. We know what they're telling us. We know they're telling us there's a coronavirus out there, you know, and that we could get sick, but we don't really know, because we don't really know what's going on. I mean, I'm not saying I don't believe there's a virus. I believe there's a virus, and I believe there's people that are getting sick and dying. But I also believe that there's a lot more going on besides just a virus. I think there's a lot going on, more going on behind the scenes. I think some of it's good. I think some of it's bad. But because there's so much uncertainty, and because there's so much that we don't know, what we have to focus on is what we do know, okay? What we do know is who we are in Christ, who we are in God, and we know how to connect with God. Now, if we know how to make that connection, go in your heart center, make that connection, and turn on your light, you don't have anything to worry about, because God's already promised us in His Word that He will protect His. He will protect us. So we need to go inside our heart center as much as we can. If even if you're working and you're busy and you got so much going on, you can still manage throughout your day to take just a few minutes, maybe if it's only a minute, to go inside and meditate in your heart center and just hold your light. The way I do it, I just put the sun inside my heart. I imagine the sun, and I just take it with my mind and I put it inside my heart and I meditate on the sun, and then I put the whole globe inside of the sun in my heart, and then I meditate. I just try to hold it there, and I try to just not think, but just listen. Just try to listen for God. Now, this will work, and if you're not used to doing it, it may take you a while to learn how to hold your focus on the light, but if you practice it enough, you can do it. I think we need to do this. I think it's important. I think it's the most important thing we can do right now is to make that connection with our God source and know who we are. Because this is the time when we all need to come together, when our world is shaking. And I know for some people it may not seem like our world is shaking, but for me, the world is shaking. Things are shaking up. I know what they're saying, but I don't really know what's happening. You know, so I have to trust God. I have to go inside my heart. I have to turn on my light, and I have to trust God, and I have to trust that God knows everything that's happening, and that God is protecting me and my family. But not only me and my family, but the whole of humanity. So we have to hold the light, not just for ourselves and our family, but for the whole of humanity. You know, because this is the ascension anyway. I mean, we're ascending. We have to hold our light. And now, I did hear somebody say today, I don't remember her name, so I can't recall it, but she said that she felt like God was telling her, and a lot of other people was saying to her that they felt like God was telling them that to hold their light, to hold their light, to hold their light, to hold their light, lift up the world and hold the light, anchor in your light, anchor in your light. And you know, when she said that, I couldn't believe she said it, because that's exactly what I've been receiving from God. It's like, turn on your light, turn on your light, go inside, hold your light, anchor your light. I mean, anchor it, hunker down inside the light, just like you would in a storm. When you hunker down and you get ready for it, you got to do this with God. You've got to hunker down with God. I mean, that's the only protection we have, because when we don't know really what's happening, and when we don't really know what's going on, that's the only protection we have, is just hunker down with God. And you do that by going in your heart center. You have to leave your mind. It's very important that you get out of your mind, because if you stay in your mind, that's where all the fear, all the anxiety is. You're going to be stressed. Your heart's going to be beating real fast all the time. If you stay in your mind and you listen, and you take in all this stuff you see on the media and all this other stuff you see on in these videos, that are just, some of them are just pure fear mongering, and their whole agenda is to put you in fear, especially the media. So if you focus on all that, the fear mongering, and you stay in that mindset, then you're just gonna stress yourself out. You're gonna have anxiety. You're gonna panic. So what I'm saying is, you got to get out of your mind. Get out of your mind. Leave the mind. Shift from your mind into your heart, and hunker down with God. So that's the message I wanted to send out tonight to everybody, because we really don't know everything that's going on. So we have to do what we do know, and that is to trust God. So I'm going to want to encourage everybody to turn on your light. Go inside. Turn on your light. Hold your light. Hold your light. And when things come up and distract you away from your light, you get back inside as quick as you can and you hunker down and you hold your light and hold your light and hold your light. If everybody's holding their light inside, if everybody's holding their light of Christ, we can come out victorious. You know, I mean, we're going to come out victorious anyway because God tells us the light's already won. But we may have to go through some stuff. We may have to go through some stuff. It may get worse before it gets better. And that's why it's so important that we don't get distracted from making our connection with God. And we don't lose it. Now, I'm talking to myself too, because here lately I've been getting distracted. I've been having people, you know, send me emails about stuff that's going on, or I might see a YouTube, you know. So I'm making this video for myself as well as everybody else. So that's pretty much all I wanted to say, is just hold your light and hunker down with God. Just make that connection with the light within. And we're going to be okay. We're all going to be okay. I'm praying for everybody. I'm praying for the whole globe. Now, that's all I want to say about that tonight, but I'm going to make another video probably in a couple of days, because I want to tell everybody about Ken's, Morgellons gel that he has created. He says he's created a gel that will literally just purge your body of Morgellons, okay? He says thousands of these Morgellons particles comes out of his body when he uses this gel. Okay, so I'm not going to say a lot about it tonight because I haven't tried it yet, but hopefully tomorrow I'll be able to get the ingredients and make the gel and try it. And then when I do, I'm gonna do another video in a couple of days, and I'm gonna tell you about Ken's Morgellons gel and how to make it. So, talk to you guys later. Thanks. I love you.